मॉर्निंग सर. मॉर्निंग सर.
After you are from Lalitpur.
Yes, sir.
And presently you are studying IDS?
Sir, I got into Indian Forest Service last year. So I have joined it, but I have not yet joined the training. I'm on leave.
But IDS also I find.
Yes, sir. I qualified for IDS as well, but I opted for Indian Forest Service.
Okay. You are on leave?
Yes, sir.
I find that in the last 20-25 years, people have become more religious. They have more faith in God. Is it correct or wrong?
Sir, different sociologists have read this differently. There's a growing opinion that in the last few years, people religious beliefs of people are getting stronger. One of the reasons is that in the fast-paced modern life, people need something to cling on to, something to derive strength from. So, religion is a tool which is serving that purpose. On the other hand, we are also seeing that the number of people who don't entirely believe in God is also increasing. So, sir, both situations are happening, but the demographics are the
okay. Equality. How many types of equality?
Sir, the base of it, equality can be. We can use the preamble to see how many types of equality are there. We have there's political equality, there's economic equality that we talk about, and there's social equality as well, which is considered.
Equality of opportunity, equality of before the law.
Yes, sir. Equality. Yes, sir. There's also equality before the
protection.
Law.
Yes, equal sir. Protection.
Equal protection of the law, and then equal opportunities that should be available to people.
Achha, okay. You studied something. What was your subject in forest service?
Sir, it was forestry and geology.
Forestry and geology. So, you read something about forestry?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me, in 1990s to, you can go up to 2005, what have been the developments in the biodiversity conservation?
Sir, from 1990s to 1990 to 2005, we have seen that Project Elephant has come into existence, under which we are taking measures to conserve the number of elephants that we have. Apart from that, in 2002, we had Biological Diversity Act. Under it, we are recognizing the rights of indigenous people over the local biological resources. And we have also amended Wildlife Protection Act as well in 2002, under which we have acknowledged community reserves, conservation reserves. So these are some major.
Globally, I'm talking.
So globally, we had a convention. We had a meeting under the fora of UN. Three conventions came out of it. UNF.
Okay.
So this is some.
Most important, you are forgetting.
So the.
Something in 1995.
Sir, the UNFCCC was implemented through.
That's one of the big ones. Something very important, at least for India.
Sorry, sir, I can't seem to recall. Sorry, sir,
some case, Godha Varman case.
I'm sorry, sir,
You have not read about that.
Sorry, sir,
Godha Varman case is famous, is still going on. And it has changed the shape of forestry and environment in the country. How the governments and institutions were behaving and now they're.
I'll check up on it.
How many volunteer services do you have?
Sir, so three. Indian.
Difficult to count. What is the difference?
Sir, All India Services, the operational control is with the state governments, and the officers are distributed across the state. Or as far as central services are considered, all the officers are directly under the control of central government.
What about postings and all?
Yes, sir. It depends on the offices of central India, central government.
The central government officers can be posted anywhere in India.
Yes, sir. It entirely depends upon the.
And All India Service officers can be posted only generally in.
Generally in the state to which they belong, to the cadre that.
Then why it is called All India? Is this normal type?
Sir, the All India by All India Services, the meaning that is to be derived is that the people who get selected for All India Services, they could belong to any state. But eventually they could be serving in another state as well, as and then the central government could also recall them as part of deputy.
Okay, you know finance commission. they devolve a lot of they recommend and that is accepted by the government. In the case of local bodies, there are two types of funds, tied and untied. Tied funds also have been recommended and those are being given to local bodies. What are those tied funds? For what purpose?
So the tied funds are usually they there are certain purposes which have been defined.
I just want to know the purpose. This 15 finance.
Yes, sir. So for example, there's the local water bodies and their conservation. That is one thing. Apart from that, sir, I don't think I'm able to recall right now.
Sanitation. Okay, you had electrical engineering from IIT Kanpur, right?
Yes, sir.
Then what is the difference between electrical and electronics engineering?
Sir, majorly in electrical engineering, we are talking about current levels of current which are higher than which are in amperes. While in electronics, those currents are less in milliamperes or so. No, sir. Sir, apart from that, in electrical engineering, we usually talk about conversion of other sources into electricity. In electronics, we use that minuscule current to get some other purposes. For example, in sensors, we are trying to use it for detecting proximity and those kind of things.
But your option is sociology. Now you know what is happening in Afghanistan. Huh? From sociological point of view, how do you look at it? Is there any sociological implication of the whole thing, or there is nothing?
Sir, sociologically speaking, the current government, which will now be headed by Taliban, it would be alienating certain sections of society, which we have seen through the exodus of people from the country. Secondly, there would be impact on women of the society. We have seen that Taliban is not very conducive towards the right of women, and that is already something happening. So a large chunk of population would feel undermined by that aspect. Apart from that, even in the globalization project that we have been talking about, which has been ongoing since decades, that is something which will be hurt given the kind of developments that have preceded Taliban coming into the power and which will now happen.
You opted for foreign service also, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
But tell me, what are our concerns? Should we be bothered or just tiny country compared to India?
Sir, we have seen that Pakistan has been supporting Taliban and it considers Afghanistan as an area which provides strategic...
Only Pakistan?
Sir, there are other countries as well. In the earlier times, we have evidence of countries like Saudi Arabia also supporting Taliban. So, sir, but one of the... Since we have better relations with Saudi Arabia right now, one of the major concerns going forward for India is going to be the support of Pakistan to Taliban and... the factor that these now that Taliban has Afghanistan under its control, it could be used as a safe harbor for terrorists and they could operate out of it and cause problems in India.
You didn't mention China at all.
Yes, sir. China. Yes, sir. China is...
You think they'll keep away?
No, sir. China is already developing relations with Taliban and it has some projects undergoing in Afghanistan. Those projects will also probably continue.
Last question, what is FRBM?
Sir, FRBM Act was passed in 2003, Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act. It was later amended in...
So what does it give? Does it give any roadmap?
Yes, sir. Sir, the amended act provides for reducing fiscal deficit to around 3% by 2024. It also talks about reducing the revenue deficit and the public debt of the governments. The central government has to be limited to 40%, while that of state governments has to be limited to 20%.
What is internal brain drain?
Sir, internal brain drain has two aspects that we can talk about. One of which is the brain drain within the country. For example, people from less developed part of the countries like UP or Bihar, they move out to better developed parts where we have... economic and education opportunities. And we can also talk about brain drain in the sense that the public sector or the state is not attracting many people, not educated or otherwise, and they rather chose working for MNCs or other such.
How do you see IITians, the bright students coming into coming out of their stream of education and field of work, coming to the public service?
Sir, in my opinion, people from technical background who have received a particular kind of education, when they are opting to join a public services, it helps in terms of making sure that the right talent is allocated at the right place. Because often we have seen that people realize what they actually want to do at different times in their lives. So, sir, rather than getting bogged down by the sunk cost fallacy, as in the problem of the cost that has already been invested, you should be future looking and see what other developments they could bring in public services. Secondly, sir, public services also benefits by having people from different backgrounds with different kind of knowledge. And so public service is paramount and it's omnipresent.
Have you heard of the term RODTEP, RODTEP?
Yes, sir. Sir, RODTEP is a scheme which aims to promote exports. What the scheme does is that it stands for remissions of duties and taxes for exported products. So the products which are exported out of the country, all the duties that have been paid by the exporters or indulging with those products, that is remitted back to them. The logic is that we don't want to export our taxes out of the country. We just want the cost of the product to reflect in the price.
Have you heard of duty drawback?
Sorry, sir, I'm not entirely sure.
The definition which you have told, that will fit into the duty drawback. Okay, and RODTEP is little different from what you said, right? Number one. Number two, why government has, after so many years, now only come out with this scheme?
Sir, earlier we had a merchandise export incentivization scheme, but that was declared as against provisions of WTO. So the government has come up with RODTEP, which is supposed to be...
What is the difference between MEIS and RODTEP?
Sir, I'm not entirely sure.
Okay. You were answering Bundelkhand non-viability.
Yes, sir.
Not only Uttarakhand and Chhattisgarh, Telangana is there. These are all good examples. And what I see is you are so much biased against the leaders of Bundelkhand region. You made a blanket statement that political accountability is lacking. How do you say that?
Sir, I do not mean to say that political accountability is lacking. What I meant was that the leaders who have suggested for carving out Bundelkhand as a separate state, they have not been preferred by the electorate. I remember the last elections, the 2017 elections, when the party running on this platform, they could only receive votes in three digits in my constituency. So, sir, I believe that there is no particular demand.
So, if they become popular, you accept separate statehood for Bundelkhand?
So that would provide legitimacy to the demand, and the accountability could flow in afterwards if such a state is created. But we'll also have to see the administrative and economic viability at the same time.
Economic viability, there are so many other states, northeastern states also, no? You have small states and all. I don't know how I can accept your argument, the economic viability aspect. The statehood is not just based on economic viability. Okay. Secondly, there is a difference between what you told. Because I was provoked, they said, until unless political accountability is attained, this state cannot become viable. That's what I said. That's why I asked. Okay. Your UP chief minister made a statement yesterday or today's newspaper, it has come. He slammed those people who are in social media being apologetic about Taliban's. What is your personal take on this?
Sir, in my opinion, different kind of statements have flown in ever since Taliban has come into the power. Some people have expect that this would be Taliban 2.0, wherein they would respect all sections of society and would make the...
No, government at the union level, government of India is making all out efforts. It is weighing various options. Is it right on a part of Chief Minister to come out with a public statement like this against Taliban?
Sir, in my opinion, the Chief Minister, a particular Chief Minister or other Chief Ministers coming out against Taliban is not something we can, is not something which should be seen in a negative light as a negative light. There are definite concerns that we have with Taliban coming in power in Afghanistan. So people should be free to express those concerns. But it's at the end of the
day. But only we have elected government at the center, and they are foreign affairs is their domain. And one state chief minister is directly attacking, right or wrong, Taliban has captured power. They are the rulers. Now India has so many options in the navigating in troubled waters. My pointed question: do you agree a state chief minister making a statement on foreign affairs issue like this when government is already struggling?
Sir, in my opinion, foreign policy of the country also reflects the concerns of different states. We are talking about we have been talking about making states as part of our foreign policy. Different states organize different conferences to attract investments, and all those kind of activities are happening. So, sir, given this kind of background, a state chief minister, if he or she has some concern against Taliban, which they feel should be a part of our foreign policy or which should be a part of our negotiating tactics with Taliban, I don't think there's any problem.
Last question. Explain Gauss law. Gauss law.
I
in electricity you might have studied Gauss law. Explain Gauss law to a common man. You are writing a piece in a popular magazine. Anybody who reads it should understand what is Gauss law, what is its practical application.
Sir, I am unable to recall right now.
So what are the characteristics of a fishy transaction?
So mostly we look at patterns. Any customer of credit card has spending patterns. For example, there could be a particular limit which they typically operate at. There are certain locations which their card is usually used. So we make use of those kind of parameters. And if let's say a person who is used to buying things typically up to 5,000, larger transaction is being made out of that credit card, it is probably fishy and it would be blocked. And for example, similarly, if a person is mostly purchasing items at NCR or at e-commerce portal, and suddenly we see that a transaction is happening in, let's say, USA or some other location which is not expected, that is something which will also be probably blocked.
HDFC was suspended from issuing credit cards. What was that about?
Sir, RBI had come up with a policy where the data had to be stored and processed in India, the payment data, but this was not being complied by HDFC. So RBI said that they could not issue new cards.
But what is the status of it now?
Sir, only yesterday or day before yesterday, they were allowed a certain, I don't exactly remember the details, they were allowed, a certain thing was allowed and some things were still under ban.
Did you watch the Independence Day speech of the Prime Minister?
Sir, yes sir, I read it.
Can you tell us some key takeaways from the speech?
Sir, one of the primary focus was on participation of the people, where the slogan of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas goes on to say that it has to be Sabka Prayas or everyone's efforts toward in making sure that the next 25 years, which the Prime Minister has dubbed to be the Amrit Kal or a fruitful period, we all have to take part in it. Secondly, there's talk of Gati Shakti project, which basically talks of investing in the infrastructure of the country. So these were the major two takeaways for me.
Post COVID, first wave and second wave, both central government and state governments have initiated various measures to help the people. Relief measures. Can you think of some relief measures that the UP government and the central government has initiated?
So the post-second wave or
post-second wave?
Post-second wave in particular. So measures have been taken to ramp up the healthcare, which will benefit the people in case there's an impending third wave. For example, oxygen plants have been, the number of oxygen plants has been increased, and even the pediatric wards in different districts has been strengthened. Yes, sir, I can't recall.
Any central government initiatives?
Sorry, sir, none that I remember in particular after this.
How has the institution of family or marriage, institution of marriage transformed in the recent decades?
Sir, in India, talking about India, earlier the marriage was more of a prerogative of the families, and marriage in India has been considered to be union of two families. We are seeing that the choice of individual is something which is gaining prominence now, and it is also becoming an important factor in marriages. Secondly, since the joint families, the concept of joint family is getting a little less traction now, we are seeing individual nuclear families coming up, where the rights of women are more respected, and their individuality is considered to be more.
We are seeing trends of live-in relationship. The Rajasthan High Court recently said that live-in relationship is against the fabric of society, and Supreme Court has a different view. What is your view on live-in relationship?
Sir, in my opinion, two consenting adults, if they decide to live with each other, that is something which belongs to their private sphere and should not be interfered into. However, I do believe that there has to be some law which defines the liabilities, or which defines the which regulates this institution. We have to come out of denial and accept that this is an institution which has come into being, and we have to make sure that we have sufficient laws to regulate it.
What do you understand by cultural lag?
Sir, cultural lag is a concept by Ogbon. It says that the technological advancement in a society, they proceed at a faster pace, and the way society adapts to those changes, there's typically a lag between the two advancements. So that's cultural lag.
You said you have been blogging from which year?
Sir, 2014.
How has the blog sphere changed in the last 7-8 years since you have been blogging?
So when I started, there were usually WordPress or Blogger owned by Google, which were used by bloggers to put out their thoughts. Now we have this changed a bit through Quora. It's a question and answer site, which later also delved into allowing people to host their own blog. The advantage with Quora was that people could write their thoughts based on particular questions as well. Then we had Medium. The problem with Quora was that the independent thoughts, which did not particularly cater to a question, those were drowned in the sea. So Medium came, and in Medium you could highlight your particular interest, and you would be able to see different posts by people who write on those topics. And now we have Substack, where people can write, and other people could subscribe via email, and they would receive a newsletter. Substack is also focused upon making sure that the creators of the content, they get paid if the newsletter reaches out to more people. Their paying mechanism is better.
So where do you blog?
Sir, I have been when I started, I was at Blogger. So the major medium that I use is Blogger.
So you still continue with Blogger? You have not moved on to Medium?
Sir, Blogger is I post my the primary medium is Blogger, but I am also making all those posts similar posts at other media as well. For example, Medium. Substack is something which I have not yet delved into.
So do you follow SEO principles when you write a blog?
Sir, Blogger allows you to develop to pick the keywords which your post pertains to. So sir, I make sure that the keywords which I am using are something which are relevant to the blog and which are typically used during finding a particular topic. So
football is a part of Olympics. Football is a part of Olympics.
Yes, sir.
Who won the gold this time?
Sir, Brazil.
Silver?
Spain.